بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we'll talk about the positron emission tomography. Positron emission tomography is type of nuclear medicine procedure that measures the metabolic activity of the cells of body tissue. Today we'll talk about the indication for positron emission tomography and the request for PET-CT and how to prepare the patient and the normal distribution of FDG within the body. Let's start. PET scan used in many indications. Most of the common of them is oncology, and also it used in the brain imaging and in cardiac viability. In the brain, it used for stroke and cancer and epilepsy and head injury. In the cardiac, for diagnosing cardiac disease and the cardiac viability. In the oncology, it used for staging and restaging and follow-up of the disease and the monitor response of therapy. FDG glucose used for cancer, staging, restaging, and therapy monitoring. Used for lung nodule diagnosis and characterization. Also used for localization of cancer of a non-primary. In brain, used for dementia, epilepsy, brain tumor. In cardiac, used for viability, sarcoidosis, and amyloidosis. This is the patient PET-CT patient request. It includes the patient name, date of birth, address, hospital identifying number, and the clinical indication. The patient preparation includes some instructions. First, we should tell the patient to avoid exercise for 1 to 2 days. Second, we should know if the patient is diabetic or not. If the patient is diabetic, we should know the medications that the patient taken. If the patient taken insulin, which insulin? Long acting or short acting? Long acting, stop long acting insulin for 8 to 12 hours before the scan. Short acting, stop long short acting insulin for 2 hours before the scan. If the patient take medication such as oral metformin, glucophage, in this case, we can do one of two cases. Either continue the medication, or if the patient complains from something in the colon, in this case we should stop metformin for 40-80 hours before the scan. Also, the patient should be well hydrated and nothing in the mouth for 4 to 6 hours before the scan, and avoid the carbohydrate for 1 day before the scan, and stop also the caffeine. And this is the instruction. Well hydrated, stop caffeine, stop carbohydrate, no food for 4 to 6 hours. Measure the blood glucose level before FDG administration. Also, after we inject the patient, keep the patient warm before starting FDG. Administrate FDG intravenously while the patient sit and lie comfortably and quietly. Patient before entering the scanner should void and evacuate the bladder. Patient will begin the image after 60 minutes following FDG administration. So keep the patient warm before FDG administration. And we'll know now why we should keep the patient warm before FDG administration. Administrate the tracer while the patient sits. Patient should void before imaging go to the scanner. Position patient comfortably on the scanner and imaging begin after 60 minutes following administration. So if we give the patient the dose at 8 o'clock, we will start the imaging at 9 o'clock after 1 hour. During this hour, the patient should be warm, and before enter to the scanner, the patient should void evacuate the bladder. And not speaking during the uptake period. This is the normal distribution of FDG uptake. As you see, the intense uptake seen in the brain, and also the intense uptake in the excretion in the kidneys and in the bladder will be intense uptake. There is moderate uptake in the liver, and there is variable uptake to the muscle, no uptake to the bone. And variable uptake also to the bowel, variable uptake also to the heart. This patient should, after we image it, we found there is of increased lethal uptake to the muscles. So we go to the patient and ask him, is the patient stop exercise before the scan? Unfortunately, the patient said he was exercising before the scan by one day. So there is increased muscle uptake to the patient. So the patient should avoid exercise for 1 to 2 days before the scan to decrease the uptake to the muscle. In this case, we should repeat the scan for this patient because the tracer go to the muscle. So we should repeat the scan to the muscle, and we should tell the patient and he should stop the exercise before the scan because the exercise will alter the distribution of the tracer. Let's start with the first question in this lecture. Chewing gum between injection of FDG and the PET scan will have no effect on the resulting image. Is it true or false? Taking gum between injection after we inject the patient and the patient will rest for 1 hour have no effect on the image. Is it true or false? I let you think for 10 seconds and then I tell the answer. So if the patient taking gum between the injection and the PET scan, it has effect on the resulting. As you see, there is increased lethal uptake to the masseter muscle and the pterygoid muscle because the patient taking gum. So in this case, it's false. It will be false. Let's take another question. On an FDG PET scan, FDG PET scan of whole body, muscle uptake can be decreased by which one of these? How to decrease the muscle uptake for PET scan? By give the patient administrate diazepam before injection of FDG, by maintaining the patient in supine position during the uptake, by minimizing chewing or talking or swallowing during uptake. All of the above, just one A and B. How to decrease the uptake for the muscle? Give the patient muscle relaxant diazepam to decrease the uptake to the muscle. Maintain the patient in supine position, no movement, so decrease the uptake to the muscle. And minimizing talking or swallowing and chewing the gum. So the correct will be all of them is correct. Muscle uptake will result in maybe the result of muscle contraction during uptake of FDG, pre-medication with diazepam, and keeping the patient spine relaxed, minimizing the use of muscle of the face and the neck. All of these will decrease uptake to this muscle. This patient have uptake to the muscle of the this patient have uptake to the brown fat. Why this patient have increased uptake to the brown fat? Because the patient have been folded between the injection and the optic and the imaging. So when we give the patient the FDG, we should keep the patient warm. This is necessary to decrease the uptake to the brown fat which present here. We can also give the patient 10 milligram of diazepam to decrease the uptake to the brown fat. Paraenteral nutrition should be discontinued for several hours below FDG. Parenteral nutrition. When nutrition may be contain glucose and glucose compete with the treater. So parenteral nutrition should be stopped for several hours below FDG. Is it true or false? Try to think. Regardless how the patient receives their nutrition, increased blood glucose will decrease the uptake in the tumor, and because the glucose compete with FDG and cellular uptake. So the correct answer is true. We should stop all nutrition and all glucose before the scan. Another question. A hyperinsulinemic state affects the diagnostic quality of FDG imaging and is typically associated with the increase of insulin. Will associated with diffuse liver and splenic uptake, diffuse muscular and myocardial uptake, diffuse stomach and pancreatic uptake, diffuse brown fat and brain uptake. Try to think. If the patient has increased insulin, it affected and affected the diagnostic quality of PET. It will be associated with diffuse liver and splenic, diffuse muscle and myocardial, diffuse stomach and pancreatic, diffuse brown fat and brain. Increased insulin will have decreased the diffuse muscle and the myocardial uptake. And this is the another question. FDG uptake by cancer tend to decline as the blood glucose and the insulin level decrease. So FDG in cancer will decrease if the blood glucose will insulin decrease, or blood will glucose level decrease when insulin increase, or blood glucose when insulin increase, or blood glucose increases and insulin decreases. The correct answer will be number. Try to think. Of course, the correct answer is number C. When the patient have blood glucose increase or insulin increase, in this case it will compete with FDG and increase the uptake to the muscle and decrease the uptake to the cancer tissue. During the preparation of the patient, if the patient taken metformin, in this case we may continue or we may stop. If we suspect that the patient have disease in the colon, we should stop metformin. Metformin will cause diffuse uptake to the colon, as we see here. FDG uptake, this patient has on diabetic drug metformin, which causes prominent large bowel activity. We should stop. To avoid this picture, we can stop hold the metformin for 48 hours before the scan. Before the scan, we can stop the metformin for 48 hours, for 2 days. If the patient come on Sunday, in this case from Friday, he should stop metformin. 60-year-old female with concomitant obesity and strong family history of diabetes, whose sugar level will controlled with metformin glucofac, is most likely to diagnose type 1, type 2 gestational diabetes or malformation. Type 1 diabetes, the patient will take insulin. Type 2 take medications, which is one of them is glucofac. So the correct answer is number B. Which of the following patient medication can be responsible for finding presenting on maximum intensity projection? As you see, increased tracer uptake to the colon, diffuse tracer uptake to the colon. So the drug which causes is metformin. The patient preparation. In this case, the patient show increased uptake to the brown adipose tissue, which is brown fat. The brown fat is present in the neck and present also in the supraclavicular region and in the paraspinal. How to avoid this finding? By warming the patient before the scan. Or give the patient 5 milligram intravenously diazepam 10 minute pyroid injection or 80 milligram of oral propranolol 2 hour pyroid injection. So before injection, 10 minute diazepam or 2 hours propranolol for 80 milligram. Which of the following region is the most common site for brown fat for fat localization? Neck, mediastina, paravertebral, perinephric. You see, the neck is the most common site for brown fat localization. Administration of which of the following before FDG dosing will decrease the uptake of radiotracer? Ephedrine, propranolol, caffeine, nicotine. Which one of these drugs will decrease the uptake of by brown fat? As you know, we take it as propranolol or so the correct answer is propranolol. Propranolol before it by 2 hours. Diazepam before it by 10 minutes. Which of the following not affect the distribution of FDG on EBAB imaging? Not affect the distribution. Intense physical activity before the imaging will make increase uptake to the muscle. Serum insulin will decrease uptake to the tumor. Serum blood glucose also decrease uptake to the tumor. Blood characterization. Catheterization bladder will decrease the uptake to the bladder. We improve the distribution to the pelvis. All of this above affect the distribution. So the correct answer will be number E. Patient preparation for FDG-PET scan of whole body includes which one of them? Nothing per mouth before imaging, fasting state at least 4 to 6 hours prior to the exam, avoiding intense physical activity the day before the exam, all of the above B and C. As you know, to prepare the patient for whole body bone scan, PET scan, we should the patient fasting for at least 4 to 6 hours. And also avoid the exercise 1 or 2 days before the exam. So the correct answer is number B and C. Okay. Which of the following condition and finding bears on FDG are correct? Non-fasting alterated the distribution diffusely. Increase uptake if the patient not fasting and taking glucose or taking nutrition. In this case, it decrease. It will be diffuse. Increase the muscle uptake. Brown fat hypermetabolism will show diffusely increase muscle uptake. Brown fat hypermetabolism focal skeletal muscle uptake. Non-fasting alterated distribution focal muscle uptake. As you know, brown fat will affect the fat, increase uptake to the fat, not affect the muscle. So B and C exclude B and C. A and D. Non-fasting focal muscle or diffuse muscle, as you see. So the correct answer number E. Which of the following scenario would result in increased regional skeletal muscle uptake? Which one of them will result in increased skeletal muscle uptake? Hyperinsulinemia, increase in insulin. Recent exercise. Brown fat metabolism. Hyperglycemia. The correct answer will be recent exercise. Okay. The ready pharmaceutical. Recent exercise makes muscle uptake to the muscle of the patient used. It's regular if the patient talking uptake to muscle of masseter. If the patient make hand fist uptake to the muscle of the hand. If it's regional because both the glucose also and the insulin also increase the muscle uptake. The ready pharmaceutical used for PET is FDG. FDG is the dose for adult 8 millicurie. Some centers from 5 to 12. Per kg will give the patient 0.1 millicurie per kg. The patient weight for 50 to 65 minutes before imaging, and before imaging the patient should void immediately before the imaging. Which dose and rate of administration is the best choice when performing a bit with FDG intravenously? Which one of them is from 10 to 20 is the the usual imaging delay between injection and scan time, we should wait at least 16 minutes. So the correct answer. Patient present for PET with FDG for suspected tumor on the left axilla. What is the best injection? The tumor in left axilla, so go away from the tumor. You should inject the patient away from the tumor in what? We can inject the patient in right anticubital vein. Can inject in left anticubital vein? No. Can inject in the foot? Yes. So the correct answer is number D, either A or C. For indication of PET in oncology, we can differentiate between the benign and the malignant disease. This is used in lung cancer for characterization of the lesion to know is it benign or malignant. Also, we can screening of a non-primary tumor by making whole body bone scan and know what is the primary tumor. Also we can use the for initial staging in the patient with many tumors and monitor the response to the therapy and distinguish residual active from post-treatment necrosis or fibrosis, and also we used for detection of tumor recurrence and staging, and also used for selection metabolically active region and the guiding for planning. So, FDG is not important for what? Not important for what? Not important for restaging of colorectal cancer? No, it's important for restaging colorectal cancer. For monitoring response of treatment of non-Hodgkin lymphoma? No, it's important for monitoring response. For detection of Helicobacter pylori? Helicobacter pylori, we can detect Helicobacter pylori by specific test in nuclear medicine called breast test, carbon breast test, but we not used in this test, we use the radioactive carbon, we don't use PET for this. We can also use the PET for imaging of metastasis of breast cancer, so the PET is not important for number C, detection of bacter. Normal FDG distribution would show the least activity in which one of them? Least activity. As you see, the normal uptake, highest uptake to the brain and also to the bladder, and also variable uptake to the myocardium. No uptake to the bone. So least activity will be to the number B for the bone. As you see, intense uptake to the brain, moderate uptake to the liver, and the variable optic to the oropharynx and the heart and the normal FDG show least activity bone. Which of the following is true regarding FDG? Its distribution in the brain is related to the blood flow, its potassium analog, its half-life of 60 minutes, it's taken by these three myocardium. The distribution in the brain related to the blood flow? No. The distribution of FDG. Another creator used embeds such as oxygen or carbon can use for distribution related to the blood flow. But FDG in the distribution in the brain related to the glucose metabolism in the brain. It's potassium analog, no. The potassium analog in nuclear medicine, such as potassium or rubidium. Both of them are potassium analog. Potassium analog used in cardiac and parathyroid and the tumor as tumor imaging. Rubidium used in the heart. The half-life of 60 minutes. The half-life is 110. It taken by disease-free myocardium? Yes, taken by disease-free myocardium. Normal uptake by disease-free myocardium. So the correct number is standard uptake value, useful for. What is the standard uptake value? The standard uptake value is formula in which we take the tissue concentration of the laser over injected dose multiplied by calibration factor. The calibration factor can calculated from the body weight or body surface area. So it's the tissue concentration over the injected dose, over the dose. Tissue over dose multiplied by the injected dose multiplied by calibration factor. Standard uptake value used for differential diagnosis of the tumor, assessing the tumor size, assessing the response, all of the above, none of the above. As you know, the standard uptake value used for assessing the response to the treatment. If there is decrease in standard uptake value, so the patient responds to the treatment. If there is increase, the patient has progressive. So the correct answer number. Good luck. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. قال الله تعالى قال سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم اجعلنا في مثال حسناتك ومن اجعل حسناتنا لدي. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.